One of the most common ways to measure the spread of our data is by looking at the 5-number summary, which gives us values for calculating the range and interquartile range. The 5-number summary consists of 5 values: the maximum, the minimum, the first quartile, the second quartile, which is also the median, and the third quartile. Consider we have the following data set. The first thing we need to do to calculate the 5-number summary is to order our values. Once ordered, the minimum and the maximum values are easy to identify as the smallest and largest values. As we calculated in the section on measures of center, the median is the middle value in our data set. We also call this Q2, or the second quartile, because 50% of our data, or 2/4, fall below this value. The remaining 2 values to complete the 5-number summary are Q1 and Q3. These values can be thought of as the medians of the data on either side of Q2. That is, the median of these data points is Q1. This value is such that 25% of our data fall below it. And the median of these data points is Q3, or the third quartile. This value is such that 75% of our data fall below this mark. Notice, Q2 was not in either set of these points used to calculate Q1 or Q3. This provides our 5-number summary as the following. Let's consider another example for when our data set has an even set of values. Again, we first need to order the values. We can quickly identify the maximum and the minimum. Remember, with an even number of values, the median, or Q2, is given as the mean of these 2 values here. In order to find Q1 and Q3, we divide our data set between the 2 values we use to find the median. This provides these 2 data sets. Finding the median of each of these will provide Q1 and Q3. For this data set, Q1 will be the mean of these 2 values, and Q3 will be the mean of these 2 values. This provides our 5-number summary as the following. Once we've calculated all the values for the 5-number summary, finding the range and interquartile range is no problem. For the first data set, the range is calculated as the maximum minus the minimum. For the first data set, this was 10 minus 1, or 9. And the interquartile range is calculated as Q3 minus Q1, which is 8 minus 2, or 6.